think about this, that he said the reason that some people don't get it is because they don't believe. They don't believe. Okay, I'll let you go on this. I'll let you go on this. Let me see if I can find it real fast. Lord, show me where it is. We were in Hebrews. Watch this. In Hebrews, the 3rd chapter, I want you to go to verse 18 and 19. And I want you, we're going to continue because that's where the 3rd chapter ends. And we're going to read the first verse. And we're going to close. Ready? In verse 18, Hebrews 3rd chapter 18 says, "And to whom swear he that they should not enter into the rest, but to them that believe not." So we see, 19, that they could not enter in because of unbelief. Chapter 4 starts with verse 1. "Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it." What God says is an automatic door slammer if you won't believe. It's not that you don't have enough money, friends. It's not that you don't have enough to make it. It's faith. It's confidence. It's your assurance in God is why you make it or don't. That puts everybody on the same playing field. And I maybe did better in school than you. And God said, the race ain't given to the swift, bread to the wise. Yeah. It ain't given to all those things that you think is why they get what they get. He said, they don't get it because of all that. He said, time and chance. Who made time? God. In the beginning, he created heaven and earth. This is when time started. For those who don't know, God existed before time. He made time. He created time. There was no time before he started time. So however long of a period before he started time, God was existing in a place where there was no time.
Wow.
And he says time and chance happened to them all. If God made time, that meant he put your chance down there in time. If God put your chance down there in time, make sure you not sleep when your time comes up. There was this one brother. He was at home. And he woke up.
Yes.
About 4 in the morning. And he saw drinks. He saw a half-eaten cake. He saw hats. He saw streamers. DJ sound equipment skipping. He said, looked over there up in the head. What happened? What happened? It was a party. He said, what you mean it was a party? He said, I missed it. He said, yeah, you were asleep. Slept through the celebration. That's what Christians do. When it's time for your miracle, they sleep in it. And depression. They sleeping in a pity party.
That's right.
Yeah. When they should be receiving what it is from the Lord, they busy dealing with all his other issues and his promise day. And the enemy done threw something at them to distract them, and instead of getting the promise, they feel with all this, they angry, they mad, they trying to get even, they doing, they on the phone, making somebody peace of mind, Facebooking, they doing all this other stuff. Come on! And they're missing the party because they're sleeping. Don't hurt nobody's feelings, but you can watch when they come back next week or whatever. They'll be in the church doing anything but hearing the word, they sleep.
Amen. Wow.
Yeah. They'll be doing this, To be sleeping God is to not be awake to his voice.
Yeah.
And you got to fight off sleep. you come around, ever read your Bible and fall right to sleep? But if you was to put on a movie, you could go like this. You know why? Because there's spirits involved. When you start going toward the things of God, the enemy is slick. I'm going to send a sleep spirit. That's why you make yourself uncomfortable when you read your word. You don't get comfortable in your bed. You get up out of the bed so that sleep spirit won't hit you. Because you'll go. Now you're going to drool all over Hebrews. Get the word going. You gotta shake it off. I said, nah. If you're going to get something, you got to be wide awake. I'm going to let you go.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to say, hold your confidence.
Hold your confidence.
Don't get contaminated by doubt. Sometimes you got to get rude. I'm sorry, but I can't talk to you right now.
That's right.
Because I'm working on, anybody ever work on something? I'm working on a miracle coming through. And you are poison to it. And I don't have the power today to fight you off and receive at the same time. I can't endure you today. I'll be with you another month or so, but wait till I get this miracle, I'll come back around. You're dogmatic about the things of God, whatever it is, because the miracle can be whatever. It's not always money. It's just whatever you need God to do for you. It's whatever you need. And the main thing, I'll tell all relationship people in here, every last one of y'all, what you got to do is quit forcing change in the other person. Make changes in you.
Yes.
You got to let them be. Let them be. Whatever they want to be. Because power comes from an example, not from complaining. If you demonstrate the power, it can be caught. It can be picked up. See, the power, it's so much power that shadows could heal somebody, right? So you just want the power, not the power. You want the power. You want to be able to walk in a room in the presence of God because of your lifestyle.
Come on!
When you walk in a room and the power of God is on you, the conviction happens without you saying a word because God will convict when you act right. You can't have an angel in the house and not feel it. Ain't no way. Y'all remember when mothers used to walk and come close to you? You be trying to put something on your breath. You be like talking to her like this. You're like, oh, that's Sister So-and-so. She'll see every demon in me.
Yes.
The Lord just gave me a word. He said, you shall reap if you faint not.
Yes.
Thank you. He said, it's in, don't faint. He said, he that endureth till the end shall receive it. Your problems have an end to them.
Yes.
Your situation has an end. You just got to endure it.
That's right.
Mine's about to turn around. Y'all remember? when I came in here and I told you the problems I was having, I said, now watch me, I'm going to go through it right before your face.
Yes, sir.
Y'all remember that?
Amen.
Yes.
Now I'm talking about two cars instead of one.
Yes.
Now I'm talking about checks coming out of wherever.
Yes, yes.
Now I'm about to catch up. It's about to happen.
Yes.
And y'all watching it, and y'all watch me give out while I need it to be poured into.
Yes, yes you do, Pastor.
Y'all see it?
Yeah.
Y'all see it?
Yeah.
I'm trying to be an example to you. I already know how it works. I said, okay. Come on, I went paralyzed in my way in, and I couldn't do it. I want you to see it. Y'all remember last week? My baby was saying I was healed. The baby was praying it was so bad.
Yes.
And sometimes when we actually see the miracles in front of our face, we just shine them off like that. That was hell what I went through.
Yeah.
God. Yeah. I got to stand, I'm sorry, but that was hell. That wasn't easy. It just had to be done. Mm-hmm. It don't feel good when you're going through.
Yes, 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 yes.
So I pray for you right now that God will protect you and cover you and help you and bless you and just order your footsteps. I know they already are. But he says, we have not because we ask. Even though he knows the ending of it, we're still supposed to go through procedures. So I pray, not because you don't know, but because you do. And I'm praying out of obedience that you're going to bless each and every person in here. But every situation that's going on in their life, you got something to say or do about it. In Jesus' name, y'all be whole as you go. Amen.
Amen.